everybody. I'm Jason Martin with Speedway Motors. We're out here today at the 305 Racesaver Nationals at Eagle Raceway. We're just walking through the pit area asking some of the drivers if they have any good ideas or looking for advice or wanting to know how they can do certain things on their race cars, whether it be sprint cars or anything, safety-wise. So here we are with Trey Gropp. He's a young up-and-coming racer, and he actually was just involved in a little bit of a fuel incident. And so here we're gonna ask Trey, is there anything in particular that you would like us to show you how to do?
I think one thing that I'd like to see is a fire suppression system, how to mount it, properly mount it, and see how it goes and where it goes.
That's a pretty good idea. Like I said, you had a little bit of an experience here recently with the fire and hopped out on the ground and rolled around, and it would have been nice to have some fire safety in the car, wouldn't it?
Yeah, it would have been real nice.
Real good. Okay, so here we are today. We have a fire bottle suppression system that we're gonna show you how to install. And this is probably one of the most common fire suppression systems that a lot of the sprint car guys are using today. For one, it's pretty lightweight. It's an aluminum bottle, very simple to install. It doesn't have a lot of plumbing or anything, special chemicals that you gotta refill. It's just pretty much plumb it up and pull the trigger if you need it. So there's a couple other ones out there that are a little bit more complicated, like I say, but they have sensors that'll go off whenever you want them to go off, which is a good thing if you're in a fire and you get knocked out unconscious or whatever. But this is gonna be the most economical and what a lot of people are using today. So we're gonna start off. Obviously, like I said, there's a nice lightweight bottle and this mount that it comes with. And a lot of people either mount it behind the seat or down beside the seat on one of the angle rails. You just hose clamp it on. It's got a mount that mounts right to it. It works. It's really easy to install as far as the bottle goes. The thing about this bottle is you always want to keep this valve up here on the top to where it's above the fluid level inside of it. So you can't install it to where it's going downhill like that. Otherwise, it's not going to go off like it's supposed to. So you want to install it to where the bottle's going uphill. And so what you're going to do, you're going to get all these fittings and connectors and what have you. You can install these with one spray nozzle or with two. If you prefer to have two of them, you can maybe shoot one right at the fuel system, right by your feet, one of them right up by your lap, by your seat belts or what have you. But what you do is there's a T. You can run a line straight from the bottle to a T somewhere, and then you can T off of that and put your two separate nozzles on. And what these are, they're just ferrule fittings, the simple ferrule fitting that you see quite often. So you're gonna thread tape it, you're gonna put it in the bottle, you're gonna insert the ferrule fitting like so, and you're gonna tighten that down. So once you get your lines bent to where you want it, whether you're going to your coupler or if you're gonna put one line, you get that all done. When you get down to the other end, what you're gonna do is just put your spray nozzle on there and tighten everything down on that as well. This nozzle's just got a couple little holes in it, so it'll just spray the chemical out where it needs to be sprayed. So that's the bottle part. We're gonna take this off of here so it don't fall over. Once you get your bottle mounted, you get your lines ran, then all you have to do is set up your release handle here. What this is, it's just a cable that's got a safety pin in it, so you can pull the pin whenever you're ready. And all you do is just reach up and pull this, and it releases all the fire extinguisher chemical. So there's two holes in there, you just line that back up. Therefore it's got a safety. There's also a safety in the bottle here as well. You don't want to pull that out until you're ready to use it, so we're going to leave that in. This cable is adaptable to where you want it, so you can put this wherever you'd like. You can put it down beside you to where you can reach it. All you got to do is reach up and pull that thing. So if you want it on the right side, the left side, down behind the seat to where you can reach it, it's going to be wherever you want. It's the easiest and most accessible. Whenever you get that figured out, you get your bottle mounted, you figure out what length this needs to be. It's pretty easy to trim it down. All you got to do is pull that pin out of there and you get this cord right, or this cable pulled out of there, and you just trim that off to where you want. So if I needed an inch shorter, I'll just trim that off. We're going to go and cut this plastic covering off of it just enough that can slide right in this bottle. We're going to have to loosen that set screw. You just put an Allen wrench in there and loosen that set screw up so that slides right in. So see, you need about a half inch of that plastic removed. So you, like I said, you can trim that off if you need it 6 inches shorter or whatever, you can trim that off. And then whenever you get that all done, you push your cord back in there. What you're gonna have to do is make sure that it's got this hex. You're gonna have to make sure that these two holes are lined back up so you can put your safety pin back in. Otherwise, you'll be off and it won't line up. So you got that lined back up. We're gonna go ahead and install this. So we shove that all the way through there. We got our plastic sheeting removed from that, and we're just gonna go ahead and tighten this down. So what happens is whenever you go to pull that fire pin, it will release the bottle and let it spray. So again, you have to pull the trigger to make it work, but 9 times out of 10, you can reach up and grab that and it's gonna help you get out of a fire situation. So Trey, I hope this helps you get figured out a better way for you to get out of these fire situations, and I hope everybody else enjoys this video.